Art is thriving in the Cedar Valley. It's everywhere. But if you don't know where to look, you could miss it. This is your local arts perspective. This is the Arts Overlook.
For nearly two decades, the landscape of Cedar Falls has been progressively populated by an ongoing series of public art, organized by the Public Art Committee. Using funds raised from 1998's RAGBRAI, this group of volunteers began with Gateway to the Trails. Later forming ties with the city's Arts and Culture Board, together the two groups have carefully selected over 20 pieces, cultivating an outstanding collection which sets Cedar Falls apart from most communities of its size.
Communities all across the state have used Cedar Falls as a model because they've seen what it does for the community at large, and I know that for a fact because they've contacted me and other people on the committee to ask, how'd you do that?
It raises conversation, you know. It's essential to having a well-rounded, multifaceted, progressive community.
Public art also has more tangible benefits for the city, such as attracting business and promoting tourism. Some individuals and organizations have even invested directly into sculptures, such as CFU's 50-50 financing of Double Helix Horizontal, an eye-catching kinetic sculpture. Pieces can even be used as an educational tool, such as Nest in the North Cedar Nature Preserve, constructed in the wake of 2008's flood.
The students actually took time to like walk around and help design, you know, and lay out the work site. And then in the end, the teachers can form programs around that artwork, like learning about nature in the preserve and also just about art.
Non-permanent pads on Main Street also integrate college students within Cedar Falls, keeping downtown fresh with a rotating display of pieces such as Tilt Shift or Sinuit. These sculptures raise the standard of living in the city while also shaping its identity over time. Many of the pieces have become synonymous with Cedar Falls, the community taking ownership of the collection and claiming it as their own.
When you see people explain that it's ours, it really becomes a source of pride, and it just adds to our lives in so many dimensions.
Nearing two decades worth of work, both the board and the committee's volunteers show no sign of tiring out. And as Cedar Falls steadily grows, so too will its wealth of public art, further enriching the community for generations to come.